When we think of Coron, the first thing that comes to mind are the towering karst cliffs that cloister pristine lagoons and lakes. But what really sets Coron apart from similar island hopping destinations is the sheer diversity of what it has to offer. Coron has a wide array of tourist spots, from lustrous lagoons to beautiful beaches to unforgettable dive sites. They even have saltwater hot springs and, believe it or not, an African safari. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Yosh, and in this video, we're listing down some of the best things to do and places to visit in Captivating Coron. This is the part 2 of our Coron series, so if you missed the part 1 of this video, you'll find the link in the description to our Coron video guide. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. Barracuda Lake. Barracuda Lake is one of the most popular natural attractions in Coron. A short boardwalk straddles the sharp cliffs and leads visitors to its turquoise and cerulean waters. It is a deep and brackish lake, filled with a combination of salt water and fresh water. Why Barracuda? It's said to be named after a giant barracuda fish whose skeleton was discovered on its floor. But don't worry, it's completely safe. Twin Lagoon. This is a double treat for tourists. This stop features two pieces of paradise separated by a low karst wall. The first lagoon, where the boats are docked, can easily get crowded, especially at midday. The second lagoon can be accessed in two ways, depending on the tide: taking the ladder over the rock during high tide or swimming through an opening underneath the rock during low tide. Either way, take utmost care when transiting between the two. Don't leave the site without looking around, because this is one picturesque attraction. Banul Beach. Aside from the lagoons and lakes, Coron is also blessed with beautiful beaches both in the mainland and on the islands. Banul Beach features powdery white sand, limestone walls, and a coral garden. It is the usual launch stop for the Coron Island Tour, although not always. Some tour operators have their meal elsewhere when the beach has already reached its traffic capacity. Black Island. Situated northwest of Busuanga Island is Malahon Island, popularly called Black Island by locals and tourists. It looks intimidating from afar because of its distinct feature, the dark colossal karst cliffs that largely define the island's landscape. These peaks rise from a huge bed of white sand that slopes steeply and slides under the waves. It's a wide and happy playground for beach lovers. Aside from snorkeling, diving, or beach bombing, you can also check out some of its caves. The biggest can be easily accessed by climbing a short ladder. Its floor is cracked open, allowing a glimpse to the cold crystal water that filled its miniature lakes. Stalactites adorn its ceiling, and rocks covered in sparkling white silica make up its walls. Black Island is usually part of the Kalawit Safari Tour by sea. Kalawit Safari. Although not really an African safari, the Kalawit Safari Park still entices you with an experience that is different from the usual island destination activities in the Philippines. The island provides a home for animals that are not native in the Philippines, like giraffes and zebras. But you can also find endemic species like the Kalamian deer. Kalawit is located in the municipality of Busuanga on the other side of the island, so it can take a lot of time to reach. You can travel by sea or travel by land. If you want to visit Black Island too, then the recommended mode is by boat. Here are the stops when you travel by boat. If you choose to go by land, the itinerary will depend on the operator. It usually consists of 2 to 4 of these attractions. Mount Tapias. At 210 meters, Mount Tapias offers a panoramic view of its surroundings. At its summit stands a giant cross, and at sunrise or sunset, you can also witness the sky's colorful gradient. But to get to the top, you need to conquer around 700 concrete steps. But fret not, rest stops with benches have been installed along the way. For those who are not really into hiking, you can stop and take a breather in one of these rest decks. To reach Mount Tapias, you can march to the base of the hill independently or charter a tricycle. If you want a hassle-free trip, you can book a Coron Town Tour. Whatever you choose, make sure to bring enough water and sun protection. Kayangan Lake. This scenic lake can be reached after a 15-minute trek up a hill. A bit challenging, but totally worth it. But even before reaching the actual lake, you will be treated to a magnificent view of the clear blue waters halfway. This image from the view deck is what you will usually see when you search Kayangan Lake on the internet. It is hailed as one of the cleanest lakes in the Philippines. It's also important to note that the area is maintained by the local Tagbanwa tribe. Take a dip and appreciate the surrounding rock formations. Go early to avoid the crowd. Culion Island. Culion is another separate municipality but is accessible from Coron. Isolated from the rest of the world for almost a century, Culion used to be the biggest and most equipped leper colony in the world. The island has been declared leprosy-free in 2006 by the World Health Organization and is now a slowly rising tourist destination. Some of the places to visit are the Culion Museum and Archives, where you can learn more about the history of the island as a leper colony, Culion Church, Aguila Viewpoint, and other islands and snorkeling sites. You can charter a private boat via the Calamian Tourist Boat Association. The office is located at Luwalhati Park. The price is quite steep, so it is best for big groups. Alternatively, you can join a group tour from Coron. This is a much cheaper option if you don't plan to stay overnight on the island. If you are planning to stay overnight, however, the cheapest option is to take the passenger boat from Coron. There's only one trip per day per way, and the travel time is 90 minutes. Shipwreck diving and snorkeling. The battle between the US Navy and the Imperial Japanese Navy in 1944 at the height of World War II resulted in about a dozen sunken warships at the bottom of Coron Bay. These shipwreck diving spots are just a short boat ride from the mainland and are within recreational diving depth. The colossal wartime vessel wrecks are said to be some of the best preserved in the world. Here are some of the popular wrecks in the area. There are many dive operators in Coron Town, so you will have no problem booking a diving tour here. You don't need to be a scuba diver to get a glimpse of them. The vast and vibrant Lusong Coral Garden, a usual stop in Kalawit boat tours, also has a World War II gunboat that can be seen just by snorkeling. Siete Pecados. If you are curious about what Coron has to offer beneath the surface, Siete Pecados Marine Park flaunts diverse and vibrant underwater treasures. You'll find various marine species throughout its coral gardens even when you're just snorkeling. Makinit Hot Springs. After your island hopping escapade or your Mount Apias hike, Makinit Hot Spring is the perfect place to cap off your day. The hot spring bath draws dozens of tourists, locals, and foreigners, despite the considerable distance from the town center. Saltwater hot springs are quite uncommon, so make sure you don't miss this when you visit Coron. You can book a tour or just charter a tricycle to go there. Travel time is around 30 minutes from the town center. Fireflies and plankton tour. It's something that we highly recommend. In Coron, fireflies come out and fly around the mangroves at night, creating a luminous show. But it doesn't stop there. The natural illumination continues when you look down and dip your hand in the water, creating a magical trail brought about by bioluminescent plankton. You can avail of this tour through Calamian Islands Travel and Tours. The tour is inclusive of buffet dinner, transfers, and kayak fees. Unfortunately, our cameras weren't able to capture how enchanting our experience was because it was just too dark. But it is similar to this photo, not the same but close to it. This guide was written when there was no pandemic, but if you're visiting in the time of COVID-19, there may be some travel requirements that you may need to enter Coron. Check out the link in the description for the travel policies. Some detail in this video might also change due to the pandemic. If you need more information about traveling around Palawan, you'll find a comprehensive travel guide with sample itineraries on our blog, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the link in the description. If you have questions, sound off in the comment section below. Follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler. You may also follow and tune in to The Poor Traveler Podcast on Spotify. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.